There'll be more people joining us as we go along. Faces Mark, Ross, and JD Josh, and Alex. With a mic, so when we put it out there, put your hand up and we'll try and get through as many people as we can. We had some questions emailed in, so I'll start the ball rolling with that. One question which I think everyone would be intrigued to know is, what's your favourite part of the show?
Hello everyone. Firstly, unreal audience.
Yeah.
Unbelievable, thank you. My personal favourite part of the show, it's really self-indulgent, but it has to be the opening. Like, there's nothing like coming, picking up that paper, and then shouting up to Matt, who plays Henry, and watching him come down that zip line. You just see everyone, I can see everyone's lip. So I just see everyone's faces, like, gasp, come down. And then that whole prologue bit that we kind of added onto the show as our own thing, it's just such an enjoyable piece to perform, and also like some of us are running around, so we get to watch it, which is great, and watch some of these guys do their crazy. Yeah, that's my favourite bit.
Woo! Well said, well said.
Again, mine is a little bit self-indulgent bit. Although they are painful, I do really enjoy my box jumps.
kind of gets us through that number, and then you get to the end and there's a lot of blood, sweat and tears, but it is completely worth it. Yeah.
Woo! My favourite part of the show is probably King of New York with the flying.
Woo!
Hey guys, to be fair, I've got to say the same thing. Flying, I am scared of heights, but after the show, you kind of get used to it. So, yeah, same with Jack. Yeah. All right, you're right.
Hello.
Woo!
Oh, this is hard. I'm caught between two, can I say two?
Yeah.
My favorite parts of the show are CJ Bay as well, for the exact same reasons, just because of you. and the world of no. I love that, the scene before and how it builds and the song itself. I think it's just like an incredible moment when we did it.
Woo!
So we'll open it up to the floor in a second. Some of the other questions we've got, how many costumes are in the show? There's 120 costumes in the show without all the cover costumes, so today there were 120. Jamie, who plays Wisedale, Jacoby and the mayor, he has 9 costume changes. He has the most costume changes.
Wow.
There are 20 wigs in the show and lots of facial hair for those. who wants to ask a question? Where's the mic? Here. Who wants to ask a question? Pop your hand up. Face right there. Thanks.
Don't take anything too seriously. Like, we're not saving lives, we're performing. I think sometimes it's really easy to get lost in the, oh, I forgot my pirouette, or I'm wobbling today, or those kind of things. But actually, if you just take it as a process rather than try and get to the end result, go through it and enjoy that journey, enjoy that process. Like, it's a craft that we have to keep molding the entire way through our journey, no matter where you are in your training or career. So just love every moment of that. Never lose your love for it, and don't lose sight of why you started.
I would say that a lot of the time when I was training, there was a lot of feedback given that you really have to take a pinch of salt. There was a lot of the time that some people that are there teaching you might have a certain opinion of you, and it's really hard sometimes for them to shake that off. So I was told, for example, I would never be in an ensemble show. everything that gets given to you, really obviously take it and try and work as much as you can with it, but always just pinch of salt is my thing. Don't let anything get you down too much.
Well said.
Last time, and one thing I always come back to when we're doing these is working hard. Like, it's the simplest thing. It's so competitive, our industry, but working hard and being nice are the two most important things. You know, in this industry, people come back to work with you again and again. They ain't going to do it if you're not very nice and you don't work very hard. That's the key to it. Know yourself, but, you know, hard work.
Be nice. Yeah, I agree. For someone just starting as well, I would say don't be afraid to be silly and do weird things, because I don't know about anyone else here, but I remember so many experiences at drama school where they asked me to do something. What is that? Why am I like blowing air on someone's face and massaging their shoulder? Find the silliness and enjoy it and embrace it, because you can't be too cool at school. Do you know what I mean? You've got to learn.
So we have some floor again. Where's the one with the mic? Could you go over to here, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, right back? White. Who do you play, really?
Hello. I was also training in musical theatre, and I was wondering what the audition process was like for Newsies.
Well, I think it was very different for everyone. Everyone had sort of like an individual experience. But for me, I went back to my old dance college to do a class with the casting director from the show, Lucy Casson, and from that got through to the first round. So we did first round, second round, and then we had the final round. So it was, you know, we danced, we learned some choreography from the show, we sang our own song, and then when we went to the recall, we did a little bit of Carrying the Banner, we learned King of New York, and we sang Carrying the Banner. And then for the finals, we did the same choreography with a little bit more, and we sang Carrying the Banner again, and we did Jack's speech in Steve the Day. That was my experience anyway. I think it was over about a span of a month, maybe a month and a half. But yeah, three rounds plus a class, so it's quite quick.
Hey, I had a bit of a different experience. I think I was on one of the first dance audition days, and I put, like, this is my dream show, like, it's on the bucket list, and so I put all this pressure on myself, and got cut first round. There was a room of, like, 50 boys. I just got so overwhelmed, danced so badly, and came out on the phone to my agent in tears, and I knew, though, that there was going to be later auditions for parts. So then I had a think at home, I got back on the phone to my agent, like, please, when they release the spotlight stuff for the characters, can you try and get back in the room? And Lucy, who's the casting director, is a dream, and she was like, yeah, absolutely. So then I did a self-tape instead for then some of the characters, then we seen for roles, and then danced again once I chilled out, because the singing and the acting was my comfort zone. And then, so I did, I think, 5 rounds from the first one I got cut to then coming back in all the way through to finals. So I guess, it's a little thing of really don't give up, though. Like, it's, if you want it, you can make it happen. So yeah, that was my experience.
Woo!
come down here.
How long have we
got. I've actually been doing that song since I was about 16. It was my drama school audition song. So vocally, I've been trying to drill that in, but I wouldn't have been able to do that without the singing teachers at my college and stuff, just drilling in like technique and routines of how to like get your belt more sustainable and like healthier and cleaner. But for the actual song itself, there's so many thoughts in it that I think the main thing is just to stay so present in everything you're saying and to be a thought ahead of the next line. Once you said one line, there's another thought and another thought. So I think it's trying to just be really calm in a song that feels like a storm. And it's all about breath control and just staying, just really still in something that feels like utter chaos, I think is all I can really say for that one. But yeah, that's my main bit of advice.
Hello guys. Firstly, I just want to say you were fantastic. I laughed, I cried. I'm a big fan of the original. 30 years ago when the movie came out, that was when I watched it, I'm that old. I just want to know if you guys have watched the original movie and did you take anything from that? Or did you take it more from the stage performance on Broadway?
I did watch the original one when I was 19. I loved it. He loves it. So.
I think like we all watched maybe like, the 50 plus version as well as the movie version. But personally, for ourselves, like we tried to like steer away from that within the room. Like we did a lot of research on our own characters. We spent like a solid week just sitting down, chatting about characters, the history of everything. So like we didn't have an interpretation of any like the musical or any like any influences. So I think say as a group we like really bonded and like worked on our own character and self like development, which really helped us for our own characters. So we didn't copy them actually.
Cool.
Hello. Just jumping off the back of that, I think for me personally, you can really tell that as a collective, as a company, we're really gelled well and bonded together. And I think that did come down to that week of having that time to do that research and do our own character development and build our own version of what Newsies is. It's been so nice to get feedback from audiences that have been coming since previews to the current day, how the show has changed for them, but also for us, we still are finding our own version of what the show is. And I think I can speak on behalf of everyone. We're so proud of what we've created as.
Whoa! Woo!
This is for anybody or everybody, but what is your dream role and why?
Ooh.
You're
always the popular.
Alright,
here we go.
Hi, thanks for your question.
Come on!
I think, if not this, Bobby and Company.
Ooh, yeah, good shit.
For me, this is not, I just, as well, because I just recently graduated from college as well, so for me doing something like this is one of my first sort of jobs as well. So, I really can't, to be fair, there's a lot of roles that I would love to do one day and things like that, but one of them that's up there, I've got to say, is Link in Hairspray. I just think it's
yes!
other than this, I'd probably say Frankie Valli in Jersey Boys.
Oh, good shout, yes.
And
much of a singer, so I'd probably say like Mr. Mistopheles and Cats.
Oh, wow. What? I did not.
I'd love to play Bert in Mary Poppins, I think.
Oh, yes.
Either Donny Novitski in Bandstand.
Yeah. That.
Or there's a, there was a play in London and it's been on Broadway called The Inheritance. And
some people know.
Adam slash Leo Jack. I mean, that play just blew my mind. So, yeah, those two.
I think, if I'm being honest, I'd really love to create something new and be like the first person to do something like that. I think there's so many roles out there, I don't really be able to pin it down to one. So I think I'd love to take something from like a workshop stage and then like do it.
Nice.
Being involved in news has always been a dream, I think, for a lot of, well, anyone who's doing musical theatre, but a lot of males always, I think, aspire to do a role like Jack Kelly, and for me that has always been something for me that has been such a dream to hold on to. So I'd say that for Frank Jr. in Catch Me If You Can.
Ooh, yes.
Yeah, just to build on what everyone else has already said, music was it for me, especially in musical theatre. We've been waiting to play the project for 15 years, so it's
wow.
Kind of a big deal. other things, I'd love to give the judge in Sweeney a go. Time before that comes to the Henry V, I mean, in terms of storytelling parts, that's the accolade for me.
So, in terms of roles, I think mine's very slightly different. I think because, so I'm dance captain on Musies.
Give it up for the dance captain. They make it all.
And it was really interesting. Coming through college, there was a lot of kind of focus placed on playing roles and things like that. And for me, my dream all the way through college was always to dance captain. And I was always to go down the choreography route, and I love it. I love focusing on why we move and how it makes us feel and how it then translates to an audience and things like that. So for me, Newsies was a huge, huge dream of mine, and being able to be a part of it from its first kind of conception and go through prep and create and help Matt and Jane create this choreography has been something that has been an absolute dream come true. So I think further on from that, later on down the role, line, rather than role for me, I would really, really love to choreograph a show and to be able to tell a story through movement and through kind of my eyes and my way of speaking it, as I've beautifully learned from Matt and Jane that have created this. So yeah, mine's the choreography, so quite
good. Brilliant. That was a good answer. That's become more of a thing now.
I would love to be the baker's wife in Into the Woods.
Oh.
But in like deep down, I will retire a very happy performer if I get painted green and I get to be
on. I am. Brilliant. Yes.
And if that happens, I will be your queen.
Hey! Brilliant.
I don't necessarily have a dream role anymore. I like to like leave it open because you just never know. Sometimes the things you get, you have no idea how much you're going to love them until you jump off and just go into it, dive in. And if you're open to any role, I think they just become so special. So yeah, I don't know. Not a specific one, but Glinda.
Go on, sweet.
I am been fortunate to be quite a bit and a bit older, but I agree actually. And if somebody when I was training, when I was 19 or 11, said that one day I'd play Willy Wonka on Theatre Royal Drury Lane, my kids would watch me like that. You know what I mean? It is about not. I've never had a dream part that I want to play, but that moment in time when you're doing something like that is absolutely incredible. So I completely agree with Lindsay. They sometimes just creep up on you, and you're literally in the middle of the biggest hit thing in England. You're like, pretty cool. That's fine.
Woo!
Especially dance-wise, and I can imagine sustainability is key in this show, so I guess my question is, how do you get through a show, especially when you've got more than one in a day?
It's quite relatable.
So, I think for a lot of us, obviously, there's the key things like eating well, getting enough sleep and all that sort of thing. But I think for us, what gets us through every single show, especially when there's two, is just the electric energy when you walk on stage and you perform with this company. It's just, and everyone is so invested in what they do. Like what you saw tonight is what it is every single show. And to have that as a company is so special and almost an honor to be on stage with. So therefore that in itself boosts you, lifts you up and helps you do that every single night. Even when you are tired, everyone around you will lift you up. And I think that's a really special thing to be a part of, knowing that together an energy is created that just helps make these numbers what they are, day in and day out. But also sleeping and food.
Yeah.
Sorry, just jumping off the back end of that. when shut up. when Newsies came here, I think obviously there's such a hype about the show coming to England. And for me, just being able to say that I'm a part, a small jigsaw piece of this puzzle of what the show is, I feel so, so grateful. And I know that a lot of people in the show feel exactly the same about, this is my dream show to do. So there's a real sense of just gratitude for even being on the stage and getting to perform in this theatre and the amazing set that we have to play on and the lighting, like every single aspect of the show that we get to have as a company. Everyone has that moment of, this is so cool that we get to do this. And there's no sense of, oh my god, well, sometimes, oh my god. But I hardly do anything compared to half these boys that are dancing around like 8 shows a week doing the insane character that they're doing is incredible. Just to be on the sidelines and get to watch that is incredible. So I think what the main thing is just gratitude for even being here, because so many people auditioned, and just being a small part of that is fantastic.
When we were in rehearsal for this, and the boys were working so hard and really technical, and I remember, JP was like, oh my god, I don't know if I can do this today. But I was like, you give 100% of what you've got. Do you know? And I genuinely do. I think that's how you create it every single night. You don't look at the one you did last week, or the one you did yesterday, the one you did. You live in that moment, and you give 100% of what you have at that particular time.
Yeah, I just wanted to say that on that question of how we consistently do those shows, 8 shows a week, it's tough and everything, but I had to give a really good shout out to Alex and Jordan, dance captain, assistant dance captain, just because of what they've created for us, preparing for these shows, and there's ice baths like way behind them, like that for us and everything, and they sort that for us, and that for me is a big help getting through the show. And I just wanted to say thank you to them.
Okay, can we stay there where you are?
So, costume to Mike, maybe. Did you get to say in any of the costumes so that you knew you could use a movie for them, or were they all made for you and you just had to go with them?
So, was that saying in what costumes you were?
Yeah, did you get a say in what you wore, or did you get to help design them, or were they just done for you?
We have an incredible designer and an incredible design team that have sort of visualized this whole thing, and one of the first things we do in rehearsal is we look at the set and come up with the ideas, and then the designer comes and shows like a movie board with all the ideas around the costumes and talks through like what is that trying to say, what's the imagery creating there. So largely we like are given a lot of our sort of design and sort of it aids us in creating our characters through the rehearsal process. But at the same time, early on, when we were doing all the research that people were talking about, Matt got us to write down an object that our characters would cherish as, and we could create that, you know, as we're creating our backstories. So we all got the opportunity to choose one thing that our character would carry with them throughout the whole show. And everyone's got their different things, and it's sort of based on what they're creative. But yeah, that's the only thing that we sort of had an input into. So he's got his cross, you know, things like that. Yeah.
the individual objects, an object that your character cherishes, was a really useful way of sort of getting into the character. And I chose rosary beads mostly off that opening line of Jack's Set for Sunday, where you lie around all day. Obviously Jack has seen something he put to where it's important to him, and I wanted something to ingratiate that into himself. That said, when I went for a first costume fitting, there were a few different sort of styles on the rail, trousers, shirt, waistcoat, maybe. But when I saw the dungarees, I said, I'm wearing those when I'm walking, and that was it. That was it. Dungarees. True story.
I don't know if people recognise the ensemble like track of the sling that I wear when I'm on my ensemble track. So I never felt so supported by a costume department, ever. So on day two of rehearsals, I had a really bad injury, I'm fine now, but basically my hand during previews was in like a big cast, and from the minute I came back from hospital, the costume department straight away said, what do you need, like, to help this? So for the whole number now, I'm in a sling, because it just gives me much more confidence to dance in it, my hand's still a bit rubbish, but so that's why I have a sling for that bit. But honestly, that was the most supportive I've ever felt by any costume department. But they could have just said, your hand's better now, learn the choreography properly and then crack on. but instead, this whole time, they've let me feel comfortable and do what I need to do the performance. So it's been amazing for me, for them.
Personally, I'm a big fan and I've seen it twice now. With my mum. But if you had to choose someone else's character to play, who would it be?
Ooh.
Right, quick fire down the line.
this is going to be good. Here we go.
Yeah,
roll swap. Roll swap. Hey!
Davey?
Hannah. Punter.
Oh.
Oscar Delancey.
To your approval.
I'd like to think I could, in my dreams, do what Mark does. So if I'm sleeping, in real life, probably Pulitzer.
Right. Thank you, guys. That was really, really lovely to see each other if you turn up for these events. Like, amazing, so many of you have supported the show the way you do. It's truly, truly appreciated. So, thank you for staying around. I hope you enjoyed yourself. Safe journey home, and we'll see you again soon.